Hey guys, welcome back to Shelby on Safari. I hope you're well and ready to celebrate World Manatee Awareness Month, because that indeed is what the month of November is all about. And so we're gonna go over five things that you need to know about these amazing animals. And then stick around till the end, because my friend Sean from Whatever the Weather Animals and I have a bit of a friendly competition going on. In fact, I'm gonna challenge her to something rather not related to manatees at all, but it's still awesome nonetheless, and it involves the beautiful leaves that you see behind me. But first, before we do get sorted with all this silliness and manatee-ness, if you want to learn all about animals, whether that be in the wild or in pop culture, be sure to hit that subscribe button and make that bell go ding so you can be the first to see all the new content. Now, let's dive right in. Manatees are in a family of their own, quite literally, Sirenia. And no, I'm not talking about the Norwegian Gothic metal band. I'm in fact talking about the classification Sirenia. Not only are manatees in this group, but also dugongs. The lineage of Sirenians goes back 50 million years. There used to be 35 different species over this time period, but today we only have 4 that belong to 2 different families, the dugong and the manatees. So the first of the 3 manatee species is the Amazonian manatee. Not only are they the smallest manatee species, but they are also the only ones to occur exclusively in freshwater environments. Next up is the West African manatee. Now, there's not much known about these guys. However, they seem to prefer feeding and moving during the night. Last but certainly not least is the West Indian manatee. Now, this species is further divided into 2 subspecies, Florida manatees and the Antillean manatee. The West Indian manatee weighs around 500 kilograms. However, they don't actually have a thick layer of insulating body fat, and they also have an extremely low metabolic rate, which explains why they prefer to stay in water that is more than 20 degrees Celsius. However, they can endure temperatures that are as low as 13.5 degrees Celsius. Manatees certainly have earned their nickname, sea cows, for they eat water grasses, weeds, and algae. In fact, a manatee can eat a tenth of its own weight in just 24 hours. But how do they chew these grasses? Well, their teeth are called marching molars. This is because throughout the manatee's life, the molars are constantly replaced. As the front teeth are grinded down and eventually fall out, the molars will fully emerge, pushing new teeth forward. Say cheese! Or I guess, seagrass! Since they spend 6 to 8 hours a day eating it. My favorite thing about manatees, though, are their lungs. They run along their spines on the top of their body, and using their ribcage muscles, they can make their lung volume smaller and their bodies more dense. This is what they use instead of actively swimming up and down. Even when they sleep, their ribcage muscles will relax. That allows their lung volume to expand, gently carrying them up to the surface to breathe. After getting some air, their muscles will contract and the manatee will sink back down under the water. You are what you eat. And apparently, that holds true for manatees. In 2019, a study was done comparing the gut bacteria of wild manatees versus captive ones. And they definitely saw a difference in the gut bacteria of both of these populations. They believe diet may have played a big part in this, since captive manatees were mainly fed terrestrial plants, whereas wild manatees consume a lot of freshwater plants and seagrasses. Manatees, like their distant relative the elephant, are gentle giants. They have no natural predators or enemies. However, their population numbers are declining. For more information, check out links in the description below.
So, the challenge is, spend 10 minutes in a beautiful greenery spot and try to catch as many leaves as possible in 10 minutes. So, let's just see how silly this can be, especially because the ground is so muddy. Let's give it a try.
Here we go.
Walking path is quiet right now, or else I'd look like a crazy person. Well, crazier. That was a close one. Well, we're just coming up to 10 minutes and I got 1, 2, 3. Good use of the dungaree pockets. As I said before, I hope you guys have more luck than I do. Maybe it's because I'm Californian, I can't actually know what a falling leaf looks like, but hey ho. Anyways, if you guys learned something new in this video other than how to not catch leaves, why not give it a thumbs up? And let me know in the comments below, what do you love about manatees? Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you next week. Bye!